The next step takes us from S3 to SF, and we get reward R3 when that happens. The first thing that happens is we update the eligibility for that state. Then we compute this quantity that we're going to add to all the state updates. This gives us R3 plus gamma times the previous value of the state that we just ended up in minus the state that we came from. And this update is going to get applied to all the states proportional to their eligibility. So we can do that same thing again, just add this quantity into all these things and simplify. Does that sound okay?
It does sound okay, and I think I finally see where this is going. So if you look at the pseudocode, right, you say for all S, you update the value of the state. Mm-hmm. If you look at the stuff that's multiplied by alpha sub t, mm-hmm. all that is basically is your error, right?
Mm-hmm. It's temporal difference error, right? That's why this is TD learning. Uh-huh.
Right. So it's what you thought it was, the difference between what you thought it was and what it turned out to be when you actually saw the reward, mm-hmm. if you assume that your future guesses about the values are right.
Exactly.
So because of that cute little compactify telescoping thing that you just did, I think without actually writing everything out, I can guess what the next values are going to look like. So, and tell me if I'm right. So the delta for VT of S1 mm-hmm. is basically going to have seen one more thing. So it'll end up being R1 mm-hmm. plus gamma R2 mm-hmm. plus gamma squared R3.
And where does that come from?
That comes from the term that you just added over there.
Well, the R3, right? And the eligibility for state S1.
Right, which you've managed to make to gamma squared. So the eligibility isn't just whether you've seen a state before. It's actually keeping track of how long ago you saw that state.
Good.
Right. And so if there was another state after SF and we kept going, we'd see that would become gamma cubed, mm-hmm. and S2 would become gamma squared, and S3 would become gamma, and so on and so forth. That's quite clever.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you would see R1 plus gamma R2 plus gamma squared R3
mm-hmm.
plus gamma cubed of VT minus 1 of S4.
Well, there's no S4. It's the final state.
I'm sorry, SF. Thank you. Thank you very much. Of SF minus VT minus 1 of S1. So that states. And all that is the error. It's what your guess was of the value and what you actually ended up seeing, which was all the rewards that you saw, plus whatever future value there's going to be.
Good. All right. Well, so we may have done a little bit too much jumping. So can I fill that in with the way that you just described it?
Okay.
So some frustrating amount of algebra and rewriting later, it seems to have fallen into this pattern. And this is what you're talking about, right, Charles?
Yeah, this is exactly what I was thinking.
So we have these sort of temporal difference-y things. So we can now state a claim, which just follows very clearly from the example. And that is that this update, this TD1 update that we just talked about, actually does the same thing as the outcome-based update, which is to say we wait to see what all the rewards, the discounted rewards are on the entire trajectory, and then we just update our prediction for the state that they started from with those rewards. Keep in mind that these things are zero, right? The SF, VT minus 1 of SF is 0. So this kind of goes away, and this kind of goes away, and this kind of goes away. And we're really just talking about the discounted sum of rewards minus the old prediction. The discounted sum of rewards minus the old prediction. The discounted sum of rewards minus the old prediction. So at least in the case where there's no repeated state, so we visit a state more than once along a trajectory, everything beautifully cancels, and what you get is exactly the same update. The TD1 update is exactly the same update as just waiting for the outcomes and updating based on that.
That's actually really impressive.